People think that their weight is completely under willful control, that they could just eat less, lose weight, and then maintain that weight loss. The evidence is that that is not true. In a dietary, behavioral, exercise intervention, only about a third of people will lose 5% or more of their body weight. And that will only be maintained for a year or two, no matter what kind of intervention it is. Why is that? There's something physical going on in the weight regulating system that makes it hard to lose weight.
Our body has devised this beautiful system. We have these hormones that signal to our brain how much fat mass, how much energy we want to carry. It does not want us to carry too little fat, and it also doesn't want us to carry too much fat. There's a sweet spot, or what we call a defended fat mass set point. Our body and our brain defends this level of energy, and that's a good thing. Our body does that for many, many other things, whether it's temperature, electrolyte balance. But what's happened in our current obesogenic environment that's filled with all of this highly palatable food, lack of movement, lack of sleep, a lot of stress, that whole beautiful system has been dysregulated, and that defended fat mass has been pushed up.
Studies have put the genetic contribution to obesity at around 60 to 70%. For some people, their set points move up more in response to an obesogenic environment. And for some people, it does not move up as much. But it's not simply that it's all environment or all genetics.
There is no question that what has changed is the environment. But the environment is doing something physical to weight regulating pathways that makes it difficult, if not impossible, to go back willfully to reduce food intake and exercise enough. And once the path is set, there's a vicious cycle that keeps going to make weight go ever, ever higher. In the past, we used to think of fat cells as a passive vessel for holding extra fuel in the form of triglyceride. But we now know that fat cells are an important endocrine organ, that there are hundreds of hormones that are produced in fat cells. And as the fat cell mass expands, hormones are produced that are critical for the normal functioning of the body, for you to maintain a normal blood pressure, to fight off infection, to maintain your blood sugar. But when they're present in excess, they are the cause of many of the diseases that we associate with obesity. According to guidelines from the American Diabetes Association, the Obesity Society, the Heart Association, and others, less than 2% of people who qualify for medical therapies and bariatric surgery are getting treatment. In any other area, this would be considered a tremendous failure.